Welcome to the Four Listeners Program. Welcome aboard, everybody. Thanks for checking us out again this week. What up, everybody? I'm Spear. On the mics with me this week, we have the mighty Ganthor. What is up, Ganthor?
How you doing, buddy?
Oh, I'm all right. How you feeling, big guy?
It's been a while since I've been introduced first.
Yeah, well, the Z-Man is out of commission this week. So it's just me and you, big guy.
What's the matter with him?
I don't know. Working, doing something.
Hurt his balls.
Oh, whatever. Whatever he's doing when he's not here. That much I can say.
Oh, poor guy.
Well, maybe. Maybe he's trying to entertain himself, because whatever is on television nowadays is bullshit. Something must be done about summer TV. So, right after, what is it, May sweeps?
You're talking to me like I know that shit?
Well, right after... Right
I
after,
thought when you said entertain himself, you meant he was trying to suck his own dick. Guess that's not what you meant.
Well, no, that's not what I meant.
So reruns on TV.
Yeah. So right about at the end of May, the major television season kind of wraps up, and then you get the summer TV season. And it used to be summer TV just used to be about reruns, nothing but reruns as far as the eye could see.
Yeah.
All right, maybe you miss something during the season, you get a little caught up with it, fine. But now with all of the choices on television, there is just a glut of bullshit. I mean, just as a flavor. I was flipping through channels, and I found a show called The Man with the 200-Pound Tumor.
Wow.
What the fuck is that about?
Obviously a 200-Pound Tumor.
It's like, there's got to be something else.
You would think, yeah, with all the channels and all the money that goes into TV programming, that...
That's the best they can come up with is The Man with the 200-Pound Tumor?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what can be done, but something must be done. Because I mean, you're looking at The Man with the 200-Pound Tumor. You're looking at Gator Boys. The big thing that people do now for the summer shows is these talent shows, because they're cheap to produce, right? Any of these reality TV shows are all really cheap to produce. So I mean, you get like the America's Got Talent, which now has Howard Stern on it. The big draw for America's Got Talent this year is Howard Stern is one of the judges.
Why would he even do that show?
I can't figure out for the life of me.
Didn't he get like $8 billion from Sirius?
Yeah. Yeah, but I think his contract is running out with Sirius, so maybe he's trying to rehab his image so that he can go off and get back into, you know, regular broadcast radio.
But why? He's got the money.
Well, I mean, at this point, it's entirely about ego. I mean, it's almost entirely ego for Howard Stern now.
No, don't just limit it to him, because it's every asshole like that. Just get yours and get out.
I guess.
What you're telling me, you would go to work if you made $1 billion?
No, absolutely not.
Yeah. So what's he doing?
Hell, I'd stop going to work if I made $1 million.
Yeah, I agree. Like, see, these idiots don't understand. The people with the money are the idiots who don't need it. They'd be happy working some dumb fuck job, doing what they're doing now, and not getting paid shit. So fuck them.
Yeah, fuck them.
That's what I have to say about that. Fuck them.
I'm with you, Ganthor.
Howard Stern.
Fuck Howard Stern. And fuck this loud-ass bitch from the So You Think You Can Dance. I don't even know what this chick's name is. Mary Murphy, I think, is what her name is.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
oh, my.
She will not shut up.
Oh, my God, dude. Nobody can get that excited about dancing.
Yeah, I know. She'd probably be pretty fun to hate fuck.
No doubt. Although the one thing I will say, though, is the hot British chick they have hosting that show.
No idea who you're talking
about. Cat Deeley.
No idea.
Kind of hot, dude.
Kind of?
Yeah, kind of hot.
Kind of doesn't work with me.
She
is or she isn't?
She is. She is hot.
So where'd the kind of come from?
Well, it's kind of what I say.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of hot.
Something's going on with you. Speaking of kind of hot, you were sending me some sexy emails earlier.
Well, you know, I was trying to
get me stiffened up for tonight.
Well, you know, anything to get a rise out of you.
Yeah, I am out of Viagra.
You need that stuff.
Shit, yeah, dude. Do you know how little I get laid?
No, I don't.
I think 13-year-old fucking masturbators last longer than I do.
That's a real shame there, Ganthor.
Yeah, it's a problem.
That's a problem. So other things. I found, you know, at least the one thing that you can get consistently throughout the summer is sports, Right, you'll get...
It depends, yeah.
I mean, at a minimum, you get baseball, right? At a minimum, yes. You get baseball all season long, all the way out through the summer, the dog days of summer.
Yeah, at a minimum. Nobody likes baseball, though.
The one thing, though, that I got to say is maybe they're stretching a little bit. Now that the NBA season's over, the NHL is over, I think maybe ESPN might be stretching it a little bit. I was flipping through, and I saw men's slow-pitch softball.
On TV?
On ESPN2.
Wait. Like national network ESPN too? National, not like local access.
Not the Ocho, right? This was ESPN2.
Okay.
Right, like,
wow. Did you watch?
I had to. I had to stop and watch it for a few minutes because I had to make sure it was what I thought it was. And it was. It was grown men playing slow pitch softball.
How do you think the pitch went for that show? It's like, oh, we got some airtime. What time was this?
This was prime time.
Prime time. Was it like a national league?
It was the USA Futures team versus the USA slow pitch men's softball team.
All right, so forget the fact that it's a legitimate league. Like, can you imagine the pitch in the boardroom or wherever it is that they do the pitches where it's like, all right, what do you got, Jimmy? And he's like, men's slow pitch fastball. And somebody goes, yeah.
Yeah, let's put that on. And the best part is that there were people who were paid to be the play-by-play commentators for this thing.
Oh my gosh.
There were people paid to produce this whole show. There's a guy who got paid to put up, you know, like this the overlay and had to put in for a statistic. You know, like sometimes they'll put like your batting average and whether or not you bat right or left or your switch hitter. This guy had to put up bats, Easton. Like, it was the type of bat they were using. Not that they were a righty or a lefty or where they were from or whatever. That they were using a particular brand of bat. Why the fuck does that even matter?
Yeah. Well, I guess so you can go out and buy your own bat for your own fucking retard softball league.
There was a guy who was paid to do that, Ganthor.
Yeah, I know.
How the fuck did I would have taken that job. How did I miss out on that job? How hard could that job possibly be?
Obviously, you didn't suck enough dick in a job line.
Seriously. And I sucked a lot of dick.
Maybe you just did it wrong. Did you use teeth?
I don't know. Nobody ever really complained.
Yeah, well, they probably felt sorry for you.
I guess.
Like, look at this guy just going to town, and he doesn't even know what he's doing.
Yeah.
Poor fella.
Yeah.
Sorry, buddy.
Yeah. Let's just move on. So let's see. What's on right now? Let me take a look. Barter Kings, reruns of The Big Bang Theory, another episode of Gator Boys, more America's Got Talent. What would you watch, Ganthor?
I would watch ping pong.
I would watch ping pong over slow pitch softball, that's for damn sure.
Yep. I would watch Demolition Derby, probably.
So here's something I would watch. I would watch a 24-hour Lindsay Lohan channel.
What? Why? No.
You want to talk about shitty TV?
You just want to see her die.
Yes. I want to see the slow deterioration of a human being.
You want to see the life just like fade out.
Just drain from her body. I want to see all the drugs she's doing. I want to see how she gets off her LoJack monitor. I want to see it. I have to.
I can appreciate that. But...
Here's something else I would watch. I would watch a show where people got nut punched for doing stupid shit. Like,
yeah, I would support that.
Like, I'll tell you what. So how about this? Here's the pitch. Here's the pitch, Ganthor. I put you in an elevator, and anybody who rides the elevator for one floor, you get to punch them in the nuts.
Yeah.
And we film the whole thing.
Yeah.
That's the pitch.
I would support that if I was a TV executive, I would greenlight that pilot.
Oh my god, that would be hilarious, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't even need sound effects. All you'd have to hear is, oh, that would just be the shit.
Yeah, I do find that amazingly funny.
Nut punches, always funny.
Yeah.
Always
funny.
Would
you allow tit punches too?
Sure.
Yeah, that would be good.
Sure. I mean, why?
You know there's going to be women that deserve it.
Yeah, well, it would be equal opportunity, you know?
Yeah. Have you ever punched Shelly in the tit?
No.
Not even, like, playful, you know, when you're getting it on?
No.
Huh. You should try it.
Okay. I'll give it a whirl. I'll let you know how it turns out for me.
You You should film it for the pilot.
I'll let you know how it turns out. Would you watch Us?
No, absolutely not. You don't think I don't have the attention span. The only thing that saves me is not being on camera and your miraculous editing.
Well, we could put you off in a corner someplace, right? We could put you off in a corner and you could be typing and playing fucking World of Tanks.
Yeah, I admit that would kind of be funny to see you guys, like, talking real, you know, animated and all that stuff. And then it, you know, it cuts to me and I'm just sitting there.
Playing World of Tanks.
Playing tanks, oblivious to the world.
Yeah. We'd just be yelling over our yelling over our shoulders. Ganthor, what do you think?
Yeah.
What?
I don't even hear it. I think I would get a kick out of that the first few times it happened. Then we'd need some new material. And I don't think we're that creative.
Well, we'd have to get you to play something else other than World of Tanks.
Yeah.
So
we'd have beer too, you know, just watch how many beers I drink.
Well, yeah, we could have like a little counter going up, how many beers you drink.
Yeah,
the Four Listeners program on TV. That might be. I think we should talk about that.
That's about all we have to offer, though. It's pretty sad.
Well, look, if it's you drinking and playing World of Motherfucking Tanks, and it's just me and Z bitching about shit, I think that's a win.
Yeah, but sometimes I have fun, you know, talking. So.
Well, then you could put down a fucking mouse and engage in the conversation.
That's true.
Well, I mean, we could have like running segments, right? Like maybe at the beginning of every show, instead of Zeth just singing his little ditty, maybe he comes out with like a full like backup dancers and, you know, lights and the whole routine.
I can't imagine Zeth dancing.
Well, I can imagine it. I don't want to see it because I can see him coming out with the booty short, with the booty shorts.
Why would you? Yeah, no.
I'm telling you, he'd come out with the booty shorts with the fucking gold lame. He'd have backup dancers, right? He'd do the whole thing. Right now, if he would be on the show right now, he'd be drooling about this.
You know, you know what I would like to do? I would like to have redo our own MXC where we take the best elements of like Wipeout and MXC and Ninja Warrior and combine it into one super show.
Well, I can see that, but I would have to make it more extreme. Like I would have to make people do like I don't know, do shots.
Yeah, they'd be drinking involved, absolutely.
Right. Yeah.
I would devise all the obstacles.
So what kind of obstacles would you put together?
You know, there'd be one where it's like it's a timed attack or whatever, where like you got to hold on the longest. So you're hanging on to something. You have to pull yourself up, otherwise you get whacked in the nuts. So people can avoid, you know, they can avoid that for maybe a minute, maybe 2 minutes, you know, and they're pulling themselves up every 15, 20 seconds. Then soon enough, those arms are gonna, you know, they're gonna turn to jello.
Yeah, see, it's not about falling off. It's about
avoiding an
up punch.
No, see, they can let go, but they're not going to fall. You know what I mean? So they're going to be, like, shackled up there.
Oh, I see.
So the only thing keeping their nuts from getting smacked is their arm strength.
So how about instead of the punishment for the nut punch is that, you know, that's part of the endurance? Is that they're up there hanging, and then, like, at set intervals, you punch them in the nuts?
Well, see, it could be like name that tune where you bet. You're like, I bet I can do it for 2 minutes. And then somebody's like, there's no way you do it for 2 minutes. And then he gets up there and he's hanging for 2 minutes trying to pull himself up over this thing that's going to smack his nuts.
Or
that would be pretty funny.
Or you'd have to deal, I think I could last 5 nut punches.
Or, yeah, that would be another challenge too.
Right, and you're hanging there, and at you know after every I don't know 5 minutes or something like that, someone hits you in the nuts, and it gets progressively harder. Right, the first one's just a tap, and then it just gets like, and then you know maybe you come out with like a little ball peen hammer, and then by the end of it you come out with a fucking sledgehammer.
That's you're taking it a little overboard. You got some repressed anger.
Well, hey, look, it's an endurance contest.
Genitalia anger.
It's an endurance contest, okay?
Dude, I got kicked in the nuts by my 3-year-old, and that hurt. You think somebody's going to be able to survive a ball peen hammer?
I'm just saying, it's one of those things where you're not only testing endurance for, like, strength, but endurance of pain.
Well, I just think you're sick, all right?
There,
I said it.
That may be, but you said you wanted to do this. I took it to the next level. And it would be funny. Everything is funnier with a nut punch.
I agree.
So then how could this be wrong?
It could be an awesome, you know, not junk. What's the word? Not, you know what I'm talking. Like
a hit.
A challenge. No, like, you know, MXC. You got to make it to the Takeshi's castle or whatever, and it's progressively more difficult challenges and stuff like that. And same with Ninja Warrior. This would be, you know, a big progression.
Right. And I guarantee, and then, the Japanese, they hang out through, they hang in there through every nut punch.
Yeah. Well, yeah, so there's two different, you've got to be clear on the challenge, right? So you're saying they bet they could take 5 nut punches and then they quit after 3, right?
Right.
Okay. Yeah, I'm talking like the, I bid 2 minutes and then he his arms run out at like a minute, then he takes a full minute of just nut slaps. You know, by some machine that's just like, smack, smack, smack.
Like a pitching machine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, I think that would be great.
that's the, instead of the hammer, maybe that's what you do. Maybe you just set up a pitching machine at 60 feet away. Just rip up the velocity as it goes along.
That would be pretty fun. And I'd like to see people in sumo suits fighting. I think that's hilarious.
So if you did like a Lord of the Rings style battle with people wearing sumo suits,
oh, that would be funny.
That I would watch.
Yeah, that would be good too.
That would be funny as hell, right? Everyone bouncing off each other.
Yeah.
And then like, you know, rolling around, can't get back up again.
Yeah.
That would be funny. That I would watch.
Yeah, you kind of get a little bit of the Mario Party aspect, where if you get knocked off, that's how you're out.
So all right, so you have a huge platform.
Yeah, right. or just like not necessarily a platform, but like something with like pits and traps and stuff.
Right, and you have to try the last man on the platform.
Yeah, or you survive a time limit, or you have to make it to the other side. People are trying to stop you.
Maybe do like a capture the flag type of deal.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you just have to have like hundreds of people in sumo suits running at each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be funny. I would watch that.
Yeah. I would too. I love seeing people annihilated like that, or like where they do the exercise ball jousting. Like, you know, you hug an exercise ball and you run at somebody, you bounce off each other.
Well, same kind of thing, right?
Yeah, yeah. I like stuff like that, so I would watch that.
There's a theme here where we're just entirely about people punishing themselves. Is that pretty much what we want
to
watch?
To it, you know, it's perfectly normal.
So we pretty much want to just see people punishing themselves. Is that?
Yeah.
All right. That's fair.
In a funny way.
So maybe that's what we do. Maybe the Four Listeners program
mm-hmm.
has these little challenges. You know, maybe we do our little spiel at the beginning. You know, we do a something must be done about something. You know, the show opens with Z in his gold lame booty shorts.
Yeah, I don't think that will last long.
What, the gold lame?
Well, the booty shorts.
Well, all right. So he comes out, he does his Z Diddy, right? With the backup dancers and the whole thing. He's got his Z dancers. Right, and then we go into the first segment with the something must be done about, and we do whatever. And then we just have the Four Listeners challenge, and it'd be the nut punch challenge, the sumo suit challenge, the exercise ball challenge, the whatever.
Yeah, we just think of new stuff all the time.
Right, I would watch this.
I would too.
So TV producers out there.
Yeah, pay us.
Come on. This is gold. This is gold.
Well, it's absolutely better than slow pitch softball.
No doubt about that. Well, what did we learn?
That ESPN actually airs slow pitch softball.
Yeah, that's true.
On primetime TV in the summertime.
That's true. We also learned that that we think we have a format here, right? We'll get Z on board with this. Yeah. We'll get Z on board with this, and we'll get the Four Listeners program, you know, on TV. God knows, with the 3 zillion channels that are available out there, somebody somewhere should put this thing on. This is how we finally get paid, Ganthor.
Yeah, that's all I care about. Really. I just want to get paid.
Just gotta get paid. So if you want to see us get paid, you want to see us get on the TV, why don't you go ahead and post it on the Facebook page, facebook.com/4listeners or 4listeners.com. For now, you're going to have to check us out on the iTunes until we hit the big time, Ganthor.
That's not going to happen.
Yeah, just search for 4listeners and we'll pop right on up. We thank you for checking us out this week, and we hope that you will check us out again next week. Thanks a bunch, everybody.